Here's a fun question for you guys. Suppose we have 2 to the x is equal to 125 and 5 to the y is equal to 128, and the question is asking us to find the value for x times y. At first, it seems that we should use logarithm, right? Because we have the x and y, they are in the exponent. But in fact, we don't have to. However, I do want to show you guys the log way first, and then I'll show you guys the way that we can just use the law of exponents. So, check this out. First, if we start with 2 to the x, it's equal to 125. Yes, we can take both sides, log base 2. So that this and that will cancel, and we just get x being equal to log base 2 of 125. Similarly, let's do the same thing right here. 5 to the y equals 128, and just take log base 5 to both sides. So that this and that can cancel, and we get y being log base 5 of 128. Now, to figure out x times y, all we have to do is this times that. So we have log base 2 of 125 times log base 5 of 128. This is an 8, not delta. Anyways, we're done. Well, kind of. But not really, because we should really simplify this expression. The results are nice numbers, so that's how we can do that. Firstly, they have different base for the log. We do have a change of base formula, which says the following. Note, if we have log of some base b of some input a, this is equal to log of a over log of b. And notice that these two logs are just the regular log, log base 10. So, I'm going to just rewrite this as log of this input, which is 125, over log of the base 2, like that. Then we multiply that by change of base formula, log 128 over log 5. Okay, now what though? They all have the same base log. Well, the key right here is that notice this right here, 125, it's the same as 5 times 5 times 5. We can rewrite it as 5 to the third power. So let's do that, and you'll see why. That's 5 to the third power. And then keep this. And the 128 is 2 times 2 times 2 and 7 of them. So 2 to the 7th power. Again, do the same thing. Yeah, just change that, and you'll see why later on. Okay, what's next though? Well, if we have a power inside like this of a log, we can bring the exponent to the front, and we'll do the same thing right here. So you will see that this is equal to 3 in the front now times log of the base 5 over log 2, and then times this right here, 7 in the front now times log 2 over log 5. And now what's happening? Well, this is log 5, and this is log 5, they cancel. Likewise, this and that cancel. So at the end, we just have to do 3 times 7, and of course, that is 21. And then we are done. So this is how you do it with log. Well, now I wanted to show you guys how we can do it this question with just rule of exponents, which is going to be much faster. Here we go. First, let's write this as 2 to the x power being equal to 125, which is the same as 5 to the third power. And then for this right here, we have 5 to the y being equal to, that is, 2 to the 7th power. Now the question is, how can we produce x times y? Here, we have x in the exponent already. The key is, we can raise both sides to the y's power. Why? Well, because now we can just multiply the exponents, and we get 2 to the xy power being equal to, do the same thing here, 5 to the 3 times y's power. Okay, so as we can see, we have the x times y here. But what's the value though? Let's look at this. We have 5 to the 3y power. I'm actually going to rewrite this as 5 to the y first, and then raise to the third power. Can we do that? Yes, because when you have this, again, you multiply the exponents, you get 3y, which is the same as this right here, right? You multiply the exponent, it gets you y. So in fact, you can switch these 3 and the y from here to here. It's actually the same thing. I think it's pretty cool. Now, the reason that we did this is because 5 to the y is what? 2 to the 7th power. We get to replace that. So we have 2 to the xy being 2 to the 7 raised to the 3rd power. Once again, we have a power to a power. We can multiply the exponents. This is just going to be 21. So 2 to the xy being the same as 2 to the 21 power. Now, they have the same base, so that means the exponents must be equal. Ladies and gentlemen, we conclude that x times y has to be 21, and then we are done, just like that.